First, let's take a look at how conformance can help your developers to write higher performance code. I have a snippet here that I've added to our web application. And at first glance, things look okay. This is fine. We're fetching some data and we're returning it from this data fetcher. But the astute observer may notice that these are serial asynchronous data fetching calls. This fetch some data is going to take 2 seconds. And instead of these two blocks executing and taking 2 seconds, they happen one at a time. And so this takes 4 seconds instead of the two like it might look at first glance. This demo code does make this pretty easy to see, but if you're working in that real big code base, this is really easy to get to sneak by you, right? When you have layers of authorization code, authentication code, analytics, application code, business logic, all brought into what you're working on, it's easy for stuff to like this to slip by. It's understandable, but this sort of code can have huge ramifications on what's going on in your code base. As I mentioned here, it only took me one small mistake for me to introduce something that should take half the amount of time. So let's say I wasn't able to catch this optimization. I'll go ahead and commit my code and I'm going to make a PR. I have this problematic code up for review and we can hope that my colleagues catch it, right? The right code owners, which we'll see in a moment, will go ahead and catch my mistake. But even better, we can automate this kind of check. As a matter of fact, if we go down here, I do have some checks here that if I go ahead and open this conformance one and check out what's going on in here, we'll see, oh, I violated the no serial async calls rule. And now I know to fix my code. I'll go ahead and I have a snippet over here and I'll just drop it in really quickly. So now we're good to go. And instead of going and waiting for my PR this time, I'll go ahead and run pmpm conformance here in my terminal. This is going to run a script from package.json here. We'll see this is conformance and this is going to run through Turbo Repo. We'll run this root conformance script and we'll run the conformance scripts in our packages within our application. So just for instance, here's the conformance script running Vercel conformance in our web application. And if I go ahead and open up my terminal here, we'll see that I'm now successfully running all of these tasks. So I fixed my errors and just to show you the speed that we get out of Turbo Repo here, if I run PN Conformance again, we're just going to hit full turbo. We don't need to redo that work. We have the same code, so we can just bring back what we already did. No reason to do that work fresh from scratch again when we've already done it. Now, the rule that I was working with here was no serial async calls. This comes out of the box with conformance in our recommended rule set. But what if you want to make your own custom rules? To demonstrate this, let's take a look at a case where we have a migration underway in the code base. A common difficulty with migrations in large-scale code bases is communicating and enforcing that new happy path in repositories amongst your developers. And so you end up with these very real problems. How do we make sure we can incrementally migrate from the old way to the new way? This is really important for large systems, that incremental path. Additionally, how do we make sure developers in our organization know to use the new way? And on top of that, how do we assign ownership of that migration? There should be someone or some ones who understand that migration deeply and are proposing that migration. So how can we assign ownership of that migration path? To demonstrate this, I've created a situation here in this code base where we're moving our component library from inside of this web application and moving it to a shared common UI package. So what we have is, for instance, we have these card and code components within this homepage that we have in this app. So you can see these being imported here from ./components. These are co-located and we see them right next to each other. But we also have these components in the shared UI package. You can see them here, card and code. So with the new way now in place, how do we make sure that the old way, the old code, that our developers know not to use it, as a matter of fact, can't use it? So what we'll do is we'll make a custom conformance rule. Now, this comes with a set of parameters that you'll set on the custom rule. The rule type that we're going to write is a forbidden import. We give it a name. We can give it a category. We can provide an error message, which we'll see in a moment. This will become a message in our terminal. We can provide an error link for a more extended explanation of what's going on, perhaps as some internal documentation. We can give a description, a severity, and the actual module names that we want to block imports from. We go ahead and add that to a rule that is on the workspace for our web application. I'll now go ahead and run this command. I'll go ahead and filter for the web application. And when I run this, we'll see that I now get errors. So let me open up my terminal here. We'll see that that message comes through. I have those two conformance errors. I'm directed right to where these are written in our code. Now, you may be thinking at this point, okay, Anthony, this is great and all, but if we're going to incrementally migrate this code, I can't just go fix all of these imports. That doesn't really make sense, right? We have this large code base that all these developers are working in. We can't make a really large PR to fix all of the various errors that we may have just created. Of course, in my demo here, I only have two violations. But at the same time, in that larger code base, there was plenty of valid code that I just may have invalidated. So what do we do here? Conformance comes with a handy utility here to handle this case. So I'll go allow list errors. And I believe actually I just left out another double right there. We'll have an allow list that is built specifically for this custom rule that I just wrote. You'll see that the name of it is right here. I have all of the stuff from the rule that I created. And then we have a list of entries that I've now allow listed for our existing code. Now, this means that if I run conformance again right now, none of the code that exists is going to be a violation because here are the two violations that we saw before. However, if I go ahead and maybe jump into this layout, and if I try to import, I believe it was a code from components code there, and I'll save this now, and I'll go ahead and run Turbo Conformance again, we're going to see that I only get that one error. I'll filter it down to web again just because that's the one we care about. Now I do have this one error. We have three instances of importing from .components, but they're allow listed besides this new fresh code that I've written after the allow list has been created. Now we can start incrementally migrating one by one using this list as a burndown list that we can see in our Vercel dashboard. So now we're all set up for an incremental migration, right? We can't backslide and write fresh imports that have this, but at the same time, we want to complete this migration. We want to, you know, go ahead and work on these. So if I am an engineer in our code base and I fix one of our conformance errors, and now I'll run conformance again and I'll pass the allow list errors, and the allow list will be updated to get rid of that error that I had before. I think my git diff will go ahead and show us that this violation that I had before, now it's gone. So I started burning down this list of those existing unwanted imports. But there is still one more question left here. I'm just going to make a very uninformative message here. I've just pushed code that, you know, affects certain parts of the code base that I'm really not an expert in, right? I helped out with that migration, but I want to make sure that someone who really does know about this migration can help me out. So what we have over here in my sidebar is, you might have noticed, we have .vercel.approvers files. This assigns ownership of the code base in that directory structure, nesting it according to the .vercel approvers files. So it looks like Gaspar09 here is one of the owners of the web application. So they're going to help me out with maybe these components. We could drill down further here, and we could have made a Vercel approvers here, and we can address, instead of individuals, groups or teams. So I could have maybe like Acme design team here, and any code that affects any of these components, that design team is going to get notified. Additionally, it looks like maybe we have here in our Vercel approvers or the UI package, it looks like we have some folks here that are the folks that are the owners of our UI package. And of course, sticking with the theme of working with your CI, if I go ahead and jump back to my pull request, we'll see that there is an owner's approvals that comes as a check on our CI. And so we have this baked into our entire process. So between these two new checks, we have a really nice structure for me as a developer to have the right folks looking at my stuff at the right times. And additionally, I have an automated check for things that I can do wrong in our code base that maybe aren't things that can be picked up by ESLint, Prettier, maybe some unit tests, right? This is just another layer of making sure that we're doing the right things at the right times to increase performance, increase security, increase code health, and really have a healthier, more scalable repository. This small demonstration is only a fraction of what Vercel Conformance and Code Owners are capable of. Helping me through that migration, making sure that I write performant code the first time. There's way more that can be done here as far as improving security, enacting certain code health qualities beyond what I've demonstrated here. So this really can help your code base scale, your organization scale, and your application scale. So you want to get started with these tools, please do contact sales and they'll help you out.